So if an earthquake were to hit, would you know exactly what to do? Well, right now, Cal OES wants to make sure that you and your family are prepared.
KCRA3's Melanie Wingo live at Sacramento State, where the agency is giving quite the shaky experience. All right, Melanie, please explain.
Yes. Okay, so right now I'm on the shake simulator, and my friend Eric here, we go way back to the 5 o'clock hour. He's going to start this thing in motion. And Eric, what do you say? What are you going to give me here, a 3.0?
7.0. We're going to give you full Richter scale.
Do they call it the Richter scale anymore? I don't think so. It's the magnitude. A magnitude 3.0 to 6.0. 7.0 is what they can emulate or simulate, I should say, here on the earthquake simulator. Eric's getting it into motion here. And I'll let you know, this simulator is all about education. We have some video to show you, too, of other people actually in action on this thing. This is the earthquake simulator that will help people understand what it's like to experience those larger scale earthquakes. California Governor's Office of Emergency Services saying it's important to give Californians a real life sense of what an earthquake feels like and why it's important to learn ways to prepare. And so far, the students out here at Sac State are interested in checking it out.
I really thought, okay, earthquake simulator, okay, like some wind maybe, I don't know. But it was really impactful, like you could really feel it hitting you.
We don't get hurricanes like Florida, and like, so kind of being prepared for our natural events, you know, it's important.
The shaking is so violent that if you tried to get up and run, you could injure yourself by something falling on your head, you could fall down, and then there's always the case for aftershocks. So it's better to be somewhere sturdy, under something sturdy, protecting your vital organs.
Okay, so Cal OES also asking Californians to participate in a statewide earthquake drill tomorrow at 10:17 a.m. And that's when those emergency experts ask everyone to prepare by doing what's called the drop, cover, and hold on stance. They're also encouraging people across the state to download the free MyShake app for alerts and drills. And back out here live, Eric and my photographer are in cahoots this morning because they are kicking it up a notch, making this thing go all to maximum capacity. If you want to come check it out, head on down to the Sac State campus through noon today, and you can feel what it's like. It's a white knuckle kind of ride. Mike and Brandy, back to you.
Is there a limit to how long you can stay on this thing, Melanie? Like, we don't want you to get sick.
Oh, no, but keep it going, though.
If there is a limit, I've reached it. I got myself some coffee a few minutes ago. I was woozy and feeling as if I needed a little Dramamine or something
to kind of tamper
down on all the symptoms of motion sickness.
Ooh, somebody get Melanie some crackers. All right, Melanie, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Now, this is the third and final stop for the Shake Simulator on this year's Great California ShakeOut Tour.